this question is about the function. For question A, find the values of the constant m for which the line y equal to m is its tangent to the curve y equal to 2x squared minus 4x plus h. We have a tangent in here in this, and here is the form of the tangent. When we listen about the tangent, this means you have to care about the gradient function. The gradient function is the first derivative or the first differentiation of the original function. The gradient function is y div, the first one, the first derivative, and we have the y the div in here. We have 4x and minus 4 because the original in this one, and you can have the y square. The y first div equal to 4x minus 4. So this is the form of the constant number, and it is a tangent for this one. And here is the form of here. And when you want to find the tangent, will be equal to the first dip. It means the gradient of this light is m. The gradient is m. So this one has to be equal to m. And now we have to find the constant of m. Another thing you can use for find this one, because the tangent and the light will have the only the one solution, is the one intersection point. For example, if I have the curve like this, and I have the tangent like here, and the curve and the point have only the one intersection point. So it means the graph or the function of the curve and the light have only one solution. So it means I will set the 2x squared minus 2x plus s. This is a graph, or this is a function of the curve, and it has to be equal to graph of line mx, and this function will have only the one solution. After I change sign, this plot. After I change side, this change position of mx from right to left, I have this form the new function. And if you want to this have the only one solution, it means the discriminant has to be equal to zero. This is a condition for the quadratic equation have only the one solution, delta equal to zero. I mean b squared minus 4ac would be equal to zero. So remember this one, and I will combine. We have the function like 2a squared minus 4 plus m, and h here plus s equal to zero. Have only one solution. Have only one solution. It means the delta has to be equal to zero. So set for delta b squared minus 4a and c. The value for b is minus here, but when we have the square, the minus will become positive. So I don't need to write the minus in here. Just care about the main b is 4 plus m. And minus 4a squared like this, and this one has to be equal to 0, and I have to find m for this equation equal to 0. 16 plus sm plus m squared, and minus what is this here, 64, okay, equal to 0. So we arrange all of them, m squared plus sm, and minus from that, you can use your calculator to solve the quadratic equation. It's not too not difficult. Okay, from here I will have m will be the first one equal to 4, And in your calculator, say that the second one is minus 12. And the question asks about the values of the constant m. So I can take the true value in here because we have no more condition about m. It's not about only positive or only negative. That's only the values of constant m. So I can finish this question in here. I hope you can understand. Okay. Go on with the second one. The function f is defined for h by f equal to h squared plus ax plus b, where h and b are constant. Solution of the equation f h will be equal to h equal to 1 and h equal to 2, and find 1i, the values of a and b. Okay, we have the information f h equal to 0, this means h squared plus bh, ah plus b equal to 0 when h equal to 1. So I will substitute f h equal to 1 squared plus a times 1 plus b equal to 0, because it is the value of f h when h equal to 1. Simplify them, I will get h plus b plus 1 equal to 0. This is the first equation. I call this one equation 1. And I will set the equation 2. F 9 will be equal to 0, but before that I will substitute 9 to the original function, h1 plus a and plus b equal to 0. So simplify it and change. So this is the equation 2. After that, I want to find a and want to find b, and I have two equations in this case, so I can change from I can set a simultaneous or system equation like this. Just rewrite it and rearrange a plus b in one side, constant number will be another side, minus 81. So both of these equations have b in here is the same, so I can take the subtraction from the bottom, from the top to the bottom. So a minus 2 s 9, you can get out 9 a minus s plus 0 b, and minus 1 minus minus 81 is positive. So here we have 80, and you got a will be equal to minus 10. We have the first question, the a is plus b equal to minus 1. So when a equal to minus 10, substitute for here, you will find b will be equal to 9. So the value of the first, the value for a and b in the first question I will be a minus 10 and b is 9. Okay. The coordinate of the vertex of the curve will be when I have the value for a and b, and the form of the equation will be a squared minus 10x and plus 9. So I will find the vertex of the curve. The vertex, it means the maximum point or minimum point of the quadratic equation graph. So this point will be like on symmetry line. So I will remember about my symmetry line formula of the quadratic equation is h minus b divided by 2i. I mean minus b 10 divided by 2i is mean 2 times 1 is 5. So when h equal to 5, it is a symmetry line. You know about the x coordinate of this point or this point, maximum point or minimum point. In the general, we call it the vertex of the quadratic equation. And the symmetry line will pass through this point. And when x equal to 5, you want to find value for y, easy. Let's substitute the value for symmetry line, value here for x, into the function. So you will have the 25 minus 10 times 5 equals 50 and plus 9. And my calculator will say that it will be equal to minus 16. So the value for x define, and the value for y is minus 16. So here is the coordinate of the vertex of this curve with a and b in the previous question. Okay, thank you so much.